لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا.
And the Sheikh, he titles this principle القاعدة الثانية, the second principle, the second قاعدة. الدعاء مفتاح زكاة النفوس. يعني that الدعاء, supplication, it is the key for purification of the souls. This is very important, right? Because you can't get into anything without the key. There's no breaking in here. And you either have the key or you don't get in. The key to purification, before the rest of the principles that come after that, if the foundation of Tawheed is established, then the key, it is dua. The Shaykh, he begins with the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, reported by At-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah, that there is nothing more honorable, more noble, yani with Allah, better than, more than a dua. And the reason why is because in supplication there is the display, the open display from the person who supplicates to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of their inability, al-ajj, that I'm unable, that's why I'm calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in it is the display of iftiqar, that a person is showing their need, that I am in need, I am faqirun ila rabbi, I am in need of my Rabb. When a person supplicates, they are showing openly, they are displaying openly that they are in need. Wa tadhallul, yani submission. Well, inkisar, yani weakness or humility in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the confession, the acknowledgement of the quwwa, the strength of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the qudra, the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani in dua, a person is displaying these things. Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah said, الدُّعَاء مِفْتَاحُ كُلِّ خَيْرٍ. The dua is the key to every goodness, everything of good. The key to it is a dua. Therefore, acknowledging, accepting, realizing that yani dua is the key to every khair, the Shaykh, so he said what? Therefore, everything of good that you hope for, that you want for yourself, from the good things of this world and the next life, then you must seek it. You must request it from Allah. And you must turn to Him in order to attain it or to acquire it. And Mutarrif ibn Shakhir, rahimahullah, he said, I remembered or I thought about what is the thing, yani jima' al-khayr, yani the thing which gathers or brings together, yani all the khayr. So when I thought about it, I realized that the khayr is much. There's lots of khayr. Yani which one is jima' al-khayr? There's so much khayr. As-sawm, as-salat, yani as-sawm is khayr. As-salat is khayr. As-zakat is khayr. I saw there's khayr in so many things. And then I also realized that khayr is kathir, but all of it is in the hands of Allah Azza wa Jalla. All of it is with Allah. Every khayr is with Allah. There's no khayr except biyadillah. And then I also realized that you, me, no one is able to have any control over that which is in the hands of Allah, except that you ask Him, and then because you asked Him, He may give you. So therefore I realized in the end that that which, yani jima' al-khayr, that which brings all the khayr together, it is a dua, because all the khayr is in the hand of Allah and nobody can get it except by asking and by Him, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, giving. So here the Shaykh, he says, and this is the greatest of the doorways to purification of the soul. So whoever knows with real knowledge, ilm al-yaqeen, anna salah al-nafsihi, that the rectification of his nafs, that the zakat, purification of his nafs, that the istiqama, the uprightness of his nafs is in the hands of Allah Azza wa Jalla, then that person would turn to Allah, laj'a ilayhi, would seek refuge in Allah, seek asylum in Allah, would turn to Allah, wa aqbal ala babihi, and present himself at the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mulihan, yani being persistent, insistent in asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through a dua, hoping for Allah's yani response, desiring Allah's response in order that that person might achieve the purification of their nafs and its salvation and its success in this world and in the next life. And it should be something that we constantly engage in, and we should realize the importance of it, the absolute need and necessity of dua if we're going to be successful in anything in the matters of this world or the next life. The key is ad-du'a.